Africa is a large and diverse region. Today, we are under siege from communicable diseases such as malaria, tuberculosis, and HIV/AIDS. Yet, non-communicable diseases such as cancer and heart disease are also growing. One of the major causes of this non-communicable disease is tobacco use. Therefore, if we successfully address this problem, the result will be a decrease in non-communicable disease as well. Thus, we are now faced with a double burden of a disease, communicable and non-communicable disease together. Our approach to controlling and reducing non-communicable disease must involve addressing the key causes such as tobacco use, and this is why we are here today. Right Honorable Speaker, ladies and gentlemen, in the Africa region, we have about 23% of adults smoking tobacco, and 43.7% of youth exposed to secondhand tobacco smoke. The trends also clearly show that these numbers are increasing, and we must therefore address tobacco use more aggressively to reverse these trends. The reason for increasing tobacco use in our region include intense marketing by tobacco industry, particularly addressing our youth and the addictive nature of tobacco as a product. To be successful, we must therefore address these key areas, build effective strategies, and implement them. To this end, member states of the World Health Organization negotiated and adopted the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, which became international law in February 2005. The convention addresses issues of tobacco control in a comprehensive manner and covers the demand side of tobacco use as well as the supply side of tobacco. It bans sale of tobacco to minors, calls for pictorial health warning on tobacco products, bans smoking in public places, bans advertising of tobacco products, and calls for increasing taxation on tobacco products. And we are happy that the Minister of Finance is endorsing the idea of raising taxation. It also addresses alternative livelihoods for tobacco farmers and urges governments to address smuggling and illicit trade in tobacco products. This convention is the key to controlling tobacco and reversing the trend in non-communicable disease. To effectively implement the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, we need to have adequate capacity within our institutions. To be successful in tobacco control, we need to have up-to-date information and act quickly on any emerging trends. That is why we are establishing the Center for Tobacco Control in Africa, to support capacity building in the region and support the rapid action required to address the growing epidemic of tobacco use. This is the first regional center of its kind, as it was said, and I am sure that it will result in better tobacco control in our African region. Right Honorable Speaker, ladies and gentlemen, tobacco use is irreversible. We must address young people so that they don't start smoking or using any other tobacco product. We must protect those who are not smoking from the effects of the secondary tobacco smoke. We must assure those who are smoking and using other tobacco products that it is possible to stop, and provide them with the information and the help that they require to stop this habit. We must not allow the tobacco industry to advertise freely and sell a product that causes misery to many people. We must tax tobacco products at the recommended levels to help reduce its use. All this time, we must build our understanding of tobacco and the tactics that the industry uses to keep so many people addicted to their product. In other words, we must fully implement the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control. I would also like to assure Uganda and this resource center that WHO will continue providing you with the support that you require to support African countries to control tobacco use and with it reduce the burden of non-communicable disease.